pledge to the flag as they march in. Please face the American flag, the salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now the Christian flag, face it and salute.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one brotherhood, uniting all Christians in service and in love.
Face the Holy Bible, salute.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path, and will hide its words in my heart, that I might not sin against God.
This time, I'm going to hand the service over to our Vacation Bible School Director, Ms. Cheryl Green, and we have a director and a co-director, Cheryl and Anita. But before I hand it to them, I wanted to let you know that our children raised $332.37 in Vacation Bible School. Our Gideon speaker, who will be here August the 6th, and the Gideons are always so glad to have that money and let the children present it to them, and so thank you for helping us raise that money, because I know it came out of your banks. Amen. Thank you for that.
Good evening. I tell you, it's been such a joy to be with all these little children, and I see one just sitting there waving, and it just warms my heart. They're all so good, and we had a total of 17 children here. I'm not talking loud enough. Anyway, we had a total of 17 children attend the VBS, and the thing I told them at the first night was that God put them here for a reason. Whether they knew it or not, God said, I want you to be here on this day to go through this. And it's been wonderful to see how much they've learned. And when Brother Gary might ask them a question, how quickly little arms would go up and they wanted to say what they had learned about God and the universe. And now I have to say to each of you, whether you know it, your baby has brought you here tonight. You're here because of them. Is that not a blessing to think that a little bitty child, 3 years old or 10 years old, is responsible for bringing a parent here? So it's up to your job to continue this with them. It's so important. I'm 62 years old, and I can tell you I would not know where my life would be without God. It is such a wonderful thing, and I'm so thankful that all of us here, have been a part of their lives in this VBS. Okay, was that good? This is my first time doing this, so I'm real nervous. We're going to have each class come up, and we're going to let the teachers introduce them, and they're going to present them with their certificates, and then they're going to do their little dance.
I'm loud enough. Okay, me and Miss Shirley had the privilege of having the little 3, 4, 5 year-olds this year, and they just did excellent. They learned about Jesus loves them and that God is in heaven. This is Catherine, and this is River, and we had two more that are not here tonight, so we had a total of four. And we were very blessed to have these children. Thank God. Okay, y'all stand right here. Hey.
So grown up, and they all acted really good 85% of the time. I cannot lie. They enjoyed the crafts where we went first, and then we went to snacks. They had out of the world snacks, some rockets from outer space and some green slime that went on those for mustard. And then they had a lesson, they learned about Jesus, and hopefully they'll tell you what they learned. I don't have time to tell you tonight. And then they got to play outside with Brother Gary. They all had a wonderful time. That was, I think, favorite time next to their music. They love music and dancing. I think our best dancer was probably Hayden. He loved it, absolutely loved it. I want to thank you, parents and grandparents, for allowing us to have your children this week and for sharing with us. It has been a true joy and pleasure. Thank you. Iris Davis. Lucas Stone. Bryson Shelton. Hayden Starr. We'll hold that for you when you do your music, okay? Kerrigan Lott. Okay, thank you. Love you all, and y'all do good.
Behind each one of these certificates, do you guys remember the night that we
we took pictures back there in the rocket ship. I printed off those pictures for you guys today. And also, remember the selfie we took the last night? Okay, those are back there for you too. So you got two pictures and you get your candy, okay? Brianna, who is not here tonight. Brianna Downs. Casey Otwell.
Woo!
Hunter Curlis. Hayden Curlis. Joel Lindquist. Micah Stone. And last but not least, Ethan Lemons. All right, I'm going to let these guys at it.
To start, and we had our youngest member, so Destiny, if you'd bring little Miss Emma up. And
Emma.
Okay, I had the pleasure of having the nursery, and I have one. So, this is it. She went around doing all the activities with some of the older kids. She had fun dancing with them. She had fun eating snacks. She had fun trying to play the games with them, getting in the way. But she had really fun, and I speak for her because I'm her mom. So it was really fun getting to spend this time with her and seeing how much she had fun with the older kids as she was dancing with them. So I really enjoyed it. I'm trying to find Carrie. Were we going to do our, will it take a minute?
You ready?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Paul.
Talk for me. Okay.
Well, I do want to acknowledge the craft. Brandy, where you at? She had a craft class. And, y'all, she come up with some of the neatest craft ideas. They made rockets. They made, y'all can hear me, I know. They made stars and galaxies. I don't know, but they had a lot of fun. She was really had her thoughts and stuff in with the crafts. And Brandy, if you'll stand, let's give her a
organized as far as who's who's. Y'all go back and check it out, and don't forget to take your kids' books home.
Okay, and you know, you can't have vacation Bible school without cookies and punch and all this good stuff to eat and send your kids home and don't all have to strip. So we had Aubrey and cookies. Oh, my mind. Where are they at? Okay, where's Vicky at?
They can't hear you. They're right there.
Vicky's in the kitchen like she has all been this week. But anyway, they come up with some really neat snacks for the kiddos. One more in the kitchen. That was Kay Morgan. I think she came one or two nights. What's Miss Kay up there? Miss Kay. Happy birthday.
about the decorations. I thought they were pretty awesome. When we started this, I thought, what are we going to do with outer space? But it's been amazing. I want you to be sure to look at all of them. A fellow church here in Queen City donated their decorations from First Baptist Queen City. And the blessing is tonight we take them down and they go to a church in Dangerfield. So we're glad that it'll get passed on and maybe another group of kids will be able to enjoy that. So, Carrie?
We are light stars, shining on through the night.
Surprised.
you get to see tonight is the awesomeness of children. And when you think they're not learning anything, it's absolutely the time they are. When you think they're not paying any attention, and you ask them a question later on, they give you the correct answer, and you wonder, how did they do that? Don't you wish you could do that? I do. But anyway, we had a great time with the children this week, and you can see that they had a good time. They enjoyed themselves, and you know what? We're going one of these days, when they get 17, 18, 19 years old, and you can get your hands on one of these videos, you're going to be able to have a lot of fun with that. Amen? Amen. You're going to have a lot of fun with that. And you know, Vacation Bible School usually excludes the little ones with pacifiers and stuff, but I'm telling you, they learn too. And so we're just thankful to have our children. You know what? There are smaller churches that would give anything to have what we have here. Amen. To have a church with little babies, moms and dads, with youth, with children, with grannies and grandpas, and mama and daddies who work every day that are raising those kids. And we have such a diversity of age groups here. It tells me one thing. His church is alive. And he's making plans to continue the life of his church. And it's our job to train the children up in the way they should go. It should happen at church. It should happen at home. And folks, it ain't easy. It ain't easy to fight with a baby, to, you know, when you're in here. It's not easy. Look at the wife back there. He discovered his voice. And he's back there right now because, you know, that's a phrase. To me, you know, we like to hear the birds sing. I like to hear the babies. Because to me, they're just saying, I got a voice. Hallelujah. You know? And that's the way we're supposed to look at these children and these babies. And you know what? I got all the time in the world to watch them grow up. And I can't wait as a pastor to see them one day walk down these aisles and bow before a holy God and receive Jesus as their Savior. That's what we are here for. That's what we work for tonight. So if I get everybody to stand, and don't get, we're going to have refreshments back here, we're going to have a time of invitation. If I get Melissa up here on the piano again, where's she at? Melissa, there she goes. She ain't paying no attention to me.
Get on my finger, girl. Can't hear you for why.
Black white. He's missing her already. Y'all, we're going to have a time of invitation. I wish it'd just be as quiet as possible. Bow your head, close your eyes. These children have learned all week about who Jesus is and what he can do for them and what he has done for them. We want to give them an opportunity or anyone else an opportunity. If you don't know Jesus, you can come now and learn him. So bow your head, close your eyes, and think about him and listen to what he has to say. Started the show off, and she's going to finish the show for us here in just a minute. But let's go ahead and pray and bless the food and and she'll be here in just a moment. Father God, we love you. We praise you. We thank you for the beauty of tonight. We thank you for the beauty of children. We thank you, Lord, for the beauty of those who are willing to give their time and their efforts, God, to make possible to teach children about Jesus. And Lord, these ladies and men and gentlemen and the youth have made it so much fun for these children. And God, we hope that they have instilled in them the desire that I want to be a part of that. And Lord, we don't know the seeds that we have planted in their hearts, but you do. And we pray, God, that they would grow and blossom until they receive Christ as Savior. Thank you for that opportunity, for that privilege. Lord, thank you for each one that has worked so hard. God, as we go into the back here in just a moment, we pray, God, that you would bless our time of refreshment. God, bless it to our bodies and bless and have prepared it. And we'll praise your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Wait.
I hear that our astronaut is supposed to be coming. You remember the first night they came in? Yeah.
Ooh, I'm on video.
Okay. Is that okay now?
That's good.
I guess I'm what they've been calling the space lady. Brother Gary says that I must be from the planet Munchkin. Mind the world when he thinks that. What gives him that idea? Well, I'm going to tell you, we have had a blast. No pun intended. And my team, Miss Audrey, boss, where is she? I think she's already back there fixing up y'all some more snacks. Miss Kay Moorhead, they've been a big help. Jessica's even helped me in the kitchen back there in the galley. Yep, there's Jessica. My granddaughter, Rachel, self, she's not here tonight. But we have had a blast. We have enjoyed fixing all this good food for the guys. And the kids have, I think they've enjoyed it. We got a little bit wild. So I don't know what these kids told their moms and dads when they came home as to what they were eating, but I guarantee you it was safe. Even Brother Gary ate a rocket dog.
I did.
With green mustard slime. It shows. Anyway, I've been traveling around in space up here, gathering up stuff to fix for y'all to eat. And I'm going to be heading on out of here in a pretty soon, and I'm going to explore some more of God's universe. I want to see more of what He's done, what He's made and created for us. But right now, I'd like to invite all of you to come to the galley and see what's cooking.
And y'all are headed that way. I want Anita and Cheryl to come up here, and I want y'all to give them a great big round of applause. Everything we do has to have a plan. God's got a plan, and He wants planners, and these are our planners for Vacation Bible School, and we appreciate the work that they've done. And you see the success of their planning tonight. So God bless y'all. Everybody, see you in the galley.